In this video, allow me to share how to be a stenographer in the Philippines. We are going to talk about the basic qualifications that the Civil Service Commission imposed on the item of stenographer in the Philippines. Various agencies do hire stenographers, but if we will notice, yung nakalagay na item ay administrative aid. Hindi ko sure kung dito ay kailangan din nila ng units ng stenography. But anyway, ito yung sample na galing sa civil service ng minimum qualification for that item. Sa Supreme Court naman, yung item talaga is court stenographer. Merong 3 levels ng stenographers sa lower court. May 1, 2, and 3. These are the qualifications naman para sa bawat level na yon. If we will notice, parehas yung qualification ng court stenographer 1 at sa admin aid 6. Yung difference lang is yung salary. On the other hand, kapag court stenographer 2, merong kailangan na relevant training na 4 hours at 1 hour na relevant experience, while sa 3 is 8 hours relevant training and 2 years relevant service. Parehas lang naman silang lahat na 2 years studies in college and CS subprof na eligibility ang kailangan. Sa Supreme Court naman po, required yung units sa stenography. For those applicants who are not graduate of office administration kasi meron na silang subjects na stenography, you can earn your units in stenography in other schools that provides short course ng some units ng stenography lang. You can check that also online. Here are some tips para sa training at sa relevant experience. Dun kasi mostly na nagkakaproblema yung mga applicants, lalo na yung mga fresh graduates. For the training, I would recommend the distance learning program offered by the civil service. Ngayon, meron naman ng online noon. You can search it para mas madali. This is a modular type of training about ethics in public service. This is equivalent to 40 hours na training, kaya sobra pa siya sa required na 4 or 8 hours na training. You can also join some trainings conducted by the CASTRAPHIL or the Court Stenographer Association of the Philippines. May mga training sila na accredited din ng civil service that you can use as a relevant training. As to relevant experience naman, for fresh graduates just like me when I applied, I had to undergo the contractual position for me to gain the required experience. Since RTC ako nag-apply, I needed 2 years. So nag-contractual ako ng for almost 3 years, including the processing of my papers for permanency. You can also use other experiences like administrative or clerkship as long as there is a certification that in doing those positions or jobs, you were able to execute or use your skills in stenography in performing those duties sa mga previous positions mo na yun. At hanggang dito na lang, I hope na nakatulong ito, lalo na sa mga gustong mag-apply bilang court stenographer, para at least mapaghandaan nila yung mga kailangan. Napakahalaga po ng mga stenographers sa hudikatura. Isa sila sa pinaka-importanteng empleyado ng judiciary. Dahil kung wala sila, walang hearing na magaganap. O syempre, pag wala din yung judge, diba? But anyway, please do consider joining the judiciary as a court stenographer. We are scarce at the moment. We need you.